Oh, guys, I just found out one of the most shocking secrets about my overprotective mother. I had always wanted to go out there to explore, see the world, live it, and make lots of friends. This is always what I've dreamt of, and it filled my thought days and night. All I do is imagine things, get lost in trance in my quiet room, with slow music playing in my head. Grace, when you're coming out for prayers, there's a battle we need to fight today. That's all I hear the time from my mom, but my dad does not even take religion as serious as she does. We can pray 100 times a day, and that's apart from the Bible reading times. Attend all the programs and meetings organized by our church. Visit almost all the members of the church. That's how I lived through my teenage years. One day, I was at the door when I overheard Mom telling my dad that she sent me to buy some things from the market, but I've not been back and it's been 2 hours now. She did not mention the fact that I was not given transport fare, and what she told me to get was a long list of food stuff, which I had to carry the weight all by myself. Moreover, with her car, she spends nothing than less than 4 hours if it was her getting this food. I was already getting fed up, but there was nothing I could do. I was yet to finish high school and had to patiently wait till I get to college before I could be free from her. About a year later, I was granted a mission to study medicine for 6 years. I was so happy and could not wait to resume. My first day in school was the worst thing that could have happened to me, as she followed me everywhere I went. To all my registrations, and even my dad tried to talk her out of it, but she insisted that she came with me. I thought I was going to stay in the school dorms, but she says I'll be coming from home, which will take 1 hour drive just to get there and back. At this point, I didn't know what to do again. 2 years down the line, nothing changed. I was walking down the roadside trying to get some fresh air when I was done with the lectures for the day, and then I saw my mom in her car with one of my course mates. I wondered if this monitoring had reached the point of having secret meetings with my friends, because that course mate told me a secret about my mom. My course mate called me one afternoon to meet her at her dorm. We have never been too close, but haven't even talked for a while. However, I guessed it must have been something really important for her to seek out my number. The shock on my face when she told me that my mom pays her monthly to spy on me. Yeah, she had been spying on me for several months, but she said she started to feel guilty about it and so had to tell me. My school wasn't even a safe haven from me anymore. My mom was hiring spies. They must have been talking about me in the car. The expression on my mom's face indicated that she was really grateful to the lady for spying on me. Next thing I knew was that they hugged. I immediately crossed the road to the other side and passed by my mom's car, making sure she saw me but pretended not to see them. I waited for her next action, but she zoomed off fast. I've never seen her drive so fast before. I got home that day and the whole house was cold. She started sending me on different errands and talking harshly to me. I didn't react, but stayed calm and obeyed every instruction she gave. Time passed and I saw her frequently in my school with other people, but I did everything to avoid her from seeing me. I spent most of my time with a friend named Kenneth. I've known him for a very long time because we attended the same middle school and high school together, and now college. However, we were not students of the same department. I've always crushed on him, but then recently realized he also did the same to me. After I found out that he had a crush on me, we would secretly meet in school because of the rigid relationship with my mother. Kenneth was like an escape route for me. He made me feel secure. In fact, he was my very first boyfriend. I was enchanted to date back in high school. Kenneth gave me my first of almost everything. Security, friendship, a kiss, heck, even sex. Movie nights, I had all things with Kenneth. After I was done with college, my father started processing divorce papers. According to him, my mom was really toxic. However, one thing he did not know was that my mom was also cheating on him. He didn't know this yet because of her pretense as a religious woman. This has blindsided his eyes to not see what she was doing. A man came to our house a while ago, claiming that my mom has a child from him. We didn't know what was going on until he said they had a relationship together. However, she ran away from him after finding out she was pregnant. The story, well, it was all true. The month we found out was really hot as we reported to the church and I kept seeing many people coming in and out of her house. Folks were just counseling my mom and pleading with my dad till he canceled the divorce. I was in my final year then, and that still did not change her attitude. Immediately I was done with school, I told my mom the plans I had and how I wanted to go about it. My dad was pleased with it, but she disagreed and told me she has plans to get a job close to where we stay. She also said that I was not yet matured enough to stay alone. I was 24 years old with a medical degree. I didn't even argue much with her, though. I just packed my bags and ran away from home the next morning without telling anybody but my boyfriend. I went to stay with Kenneth, my boyfriend, and planned on getting my own apartment soon after accepting one of the job offers I had. Well, things got worse at home as they were looking for me. Even reported to the police as a runaway, but nothing was done since I was over 18. I wasn't a minor, and I had the right to stay away from my parents. For 2 years, I was away from home receiving different calls from my father, pleading that I should come back home as I was the only child he had, and he doesn't want to lose me. He loves me so much, and so did I, so it saddened me that I had to leave him alone with my mother. I came back after more consideration, and she was just pleading with me, saying she's changed a lot and won't disturb my private life anymore. I believed her, and everything was going smoothly. I introduced my fiancé to my parents, and he introduced me to his. We did a lot of outings together, and fortunately for us, we worked in the same hospital. One day, I came back late from work. My mom has already parked outside my apartment, and I went to meet her only for her to be asking me questions about where I was coming from and why I stayed so long at a man's house. I was first confused and wondered how she knew where I was coming from and why can I not just go wherever I want. I got a 2-hour counseling on staying off of sex till I was married. She began to give stories about her and my father did not see each other till they were married, and this is a godly way to live our lives. I stayed there, staring at the woman that constantly committed fornication with boys far younger than her, and how she was spoiling their lives that early. I couldn't say anything, but just pretended to listen to her until she left. Miss Olivia lived close to us and often checked up time to time. We also go to her place to spend some time, pray, read the Bible too. I went home to visit my parents and saw them preparing to go to Miss Olivia's place. I took this opportunity to check up on Mrs. Olivia because it's been a long time since I saw her. We got to her place, but she wasn't around, so we had to wait for her. Her son Gabriel was there though, and I noticed the gestures he was giving to my mom, but my father was not paying attention to them. It was not too long that I remembered that we went to the same institution, but the connection is what I did not really understand. Miss Olivia then came in to welcome us. We spent quite a while with her because that's the only closest friend I know to my family, especially my mother, and they share a lot of things together. She got a call and stepped out to receive it. Gabriel stood up and went to the kitchen, which my mom followed. After some minutes, I pretended to be pressed and stood up to check what was going on in the kitchen. I pressed my ears to the wall and heard Gabriel telling my mom that she had not sent the money and he was going to expose her if she doesn't send it in 2 days' time. I almost tripped over while hearing this conversation. She was there during the naming ceremony of Gabriel and he was like a son to my mother, although we're not close due to my indoor habit. I immediately understood why she hardly let me out. She probably did not want me to find out so much about her. I thought she had changed truly, as she said, and my father does not deserve this, I thought as I took pictures and left. I started making plans to ensure that all her evil secrets are exposed and that this time with enough proof. On a Saturday evening, I got a call from my mother asking me of where I was and what I was doing there. I asked her what she was talking about, and she said she perceives that I was in a hotel and began her counseling on no sleeping with my fiancé before marriage. I just ended the call and put it in airplane mode. Kenneth asked who that was, and I could not give him a solid response that day. I told Kenneth about my childhood experiences. I told him how that when I'm in a company of people who happen to be around my age mates, I did not know what to say or how to react because I've always been made to stay indoors, with no means of communication with anyone out there. Every day after school, I would come straight home with tears, just throwing everything away from my side at the end, and just hopping up in the shower with water slowly dropping down, lost in thoughts and wondering what kind of lifestyle I was living. My mother literally ruined my social communication skills. There were several times that I would be on the verge of calling Social Security, but would hesitate at the last minute because I did not want to break my family apart. I only wanted freedom. I loved my father very much and would not want to be separated from him. I did not tell him about what my mother has been doing and who she truly was because I did not want to damage her image in front of my fiancé. He drove me home, tears streaming from my face. The next morning, I got prepared for work, but as soon as I was done, I went outside to wait for Kenneth to be done, so that we could go to work together. On stepping outside, I saw my mom approaching my place at 7 a.m. I was hoping nothing bad had happened, and before I could say good morning, I got a hot slap on my face. I almost fell down. Still holding my cheeks, Kenneth held me so I wouldn't fall. I stood upright and shouted at her, "What the hell was she doing? Why does she even think she has the right to slap me?" So then she asked me why I went to a hotel with a man after she warned me not to do so. She was also vexed because I cut the call on her. Kenneth intervened, took me into his car, and zoomed off to work. I called my dad to tell him what just happened, and he showed his displeasure in what she did. As a father, he advised me on what to do and that I should keep praying for her, and things might get better. At this point, I thought she had bewitched my father, because how can he even say I should pray for her? I didn't say anything anymore. I managed to finish my work that day. I didn't call her for the next 2 weeks, but keep receiving text messages from her telling me about my location and what I was doing is wrong. She kept warning me to stay away from sleeping with any man until I was married. So, that week, Kenneth proposed to me and we began to make plans to get married. I was not happy with my mother, but I pretended to be happy just to keep the peace. I went to visit my dad when she was not home. I wanted to avoid seeing her altogether. My dad needed to see me concerning his health. He needed me to do some checkups for him. After I finished with the treatment, he asked me to transfer some files on Mom's laptop to his hard drive. While I was doing that, I saw a folder. A folder that had a weird name, so I opened it, only to see so many videos of me. I quickly transferred it to my flash drive as I was sending my dad's own so that he would not suspect anything. Also, there were pictures of other men that she's been with together, and many nude pictures of her and some of other men. I went home quickly to check the videos and realized that there was a CCTV camera in almost everywhere I stayed. My house, my car, my workspace, everywhere. She also employed someone to spy on me and monitor every bit of my moments. I was pissed. I wrote a letter to her that she should not come close to me anymore, or even to my wedding that was coming up in a week's time. I told my dad to come over to my place and I handed the letter to him, so he could give it to her. He pleaded with me not to take any rash steps concerning my mother. I told him, "I've heard him, but I'll come over that evening and he should prepare for a large meeting." That evening, I invited some folks from the church, Miss Olivia, her son, my fiancé, and some other people that knew her well. After everyone was seated, I gave my speech and told everyone to tell her to avoid me. I don't want to see her close to my wedding. They all murmured and asked me to calm down before making such a rash decision. I responded to them and said they should watch a tape. A tape I had with me before they judged my decision. I then played the videos and showed them pictures of my mother with different men and the spy video she set on me. Gabriel wanted to run away after seeing himself in his nude pictures, but I was held back. I didn't feel any pity for her or Gabriel either, but for my dad, who had always stayed faithful to his marriage. She left the house even before my father divorced her. Nobody was willing to accept her, not even her own parents. My wedding came up and I had bouncers around just to ensure that she doesn't come close to the wedding venue. For the first time in my entire life, I felt so calm and safe. I looked at myself in the mirror, I smiled back and I said, "Ah, peace at last, peace at last." Okay guys, so we've had a lot of crazy moms and crazy mother-in-laws on this channel, but I don't know. That mother might have taken the cake. I mean, setting up security cameras in everywhere that OP lives, stays, goes, shops, it's weird. Okay guys, this might be the weirdest mother in all the stories we've ever read. Drop your thoughts down below what you think about that. I know, a lot of you are saying probably, Magda, the mother-in-law saga will never be beaten. And I do agree that was a crazy one, but this one's pretty intense too. Drop your thoughts down below. Our second and final story on the video is titled, OP's coworker is bragging about filing a false bite report in an attempt to get their ex's dog euthanized. Guys, if you're not subscribed, go ahead and click the button right now and let's see what's up with story number two. Sorry, this is a dumb question. I understand completely if the answer here is don't get involved. Still, I had a beloved cat get killed by a psycho when I was a kid, so I hate the idea of someone else going through a similar loss. I have a coworker who's a bit of a character, to put it nicely. Recently, they've been bragging about how they're going to get revenge on their ex by filing a false bite report. They claim that the dog will be euthanized as the ex supposedly hasn't paid for a dog license. Obviously, that's crap. But is there any way this anonymous report will result in the dog being put down? The coworker says they're willing to do it as often as it takes and also planned on filing false dog at large report. They think this is very clever and has bragged about it multiple times. This is despite them knowing that I'm a huge animal lover. Best part is the coworker broke up with their ex because the coworker was cheating and the ex would not forgive it. Even the boss knows about it because this coworker keeps bragging to him about it. This coworker is still on probationary period, and I don't think he's going to keep them after it ends. I figured calling animal control could be a first good start, but wonder if I'd be mistaken for a friend of the ex's. I just don't want to sit back and do nothing if there's a chance an innocent dog's going to be killed due to this piece of work. I've never gotten involved in a situation like this before, and I'm not overly comfortable doing so, but want to help. If I can? Thanks, guys. Alright guys, what's up? Mr. Edito here. So, there's an update for this post. If you like these office drama type of stories or anything work-related, just know, I have a whole nother channel that is specifically dedicated to office dramas. You can find that link in the description below. The channel's called Mr. Edito Office Dramas. Here's your update for the story. Hey guys. Glad to say I've got a happy update. The coworker was indeed terminated the day her probationary period ended. I wasn't working that day, but apparently she just stormed out wordlessly when told. The ex has filed for a temporary restraining order and is working on a permanent one. He's also installed home security cameras and carries a copy of the police report and a one-page vet record showing the dog is sprayed and vaccinated. The dog has also been to obedience school, and they wrote a letter saying she hasn't shown any human or dog aggression. Police and animal control are very good around here. They assured us both that the euthanasia is an absolute last resort in any case, and they'd require extra proof from this coworker should she report anything. Additionally, with the restraining order, the coworker can't be bitten by the dog without violating it, and the department says they don't allow total anonymous reports. You can keep your name a secret from the dog's owner, but not the police or animal control. So, the dog's safe, co-worker got let go, and ex is forewarned. I'd call it a win. Thanks everybody for advice and support. It just blows my mind when somebody's trying to do something illegal. Why do they go around telling everybody? It just doesn't make sense. Like, how do you think you're going to get away with that, guys? Let's read a couple comments. The first comment is a similar situation story that we'll check out right now. So, seriously, I once heard a woman boasting to her friend and the cashier at a grocery store about she had successfully faked a pregnancy in order to extort $2,000 out of some guy she hooked up with as money for an abortion that she never needed, and she bought a laptop instead. Yeah. My ex did this, says comment 2, even took me to the appointment as moral support. I stayed in the waiting room. Wasn't an abortion appointment. It was just a regular checkup. But she took me for $1,200. Guys, I want to know your opinions on this story. Drop them down below. Maybe share a similar situation you've had. Thank you so much for joining in. Don't forget to smash that like button, drop a comment below, and subscribe. Those are the three best ways you can support me, and I thank you so much if you decide to do that. If not, thank you anyways for joining and listening to these stories, and just know, Mr. Redito will be here every single day across my three channels. Check them out in the descriptions below. Have a wonderful day, and I'll catch you in the next one.